Now, a lot of people think, you know, what is he doing reading from the Bible from time to time? And then he reads all his other wayward stuff, seemingly wayward stuff. All I have to say to you folks is, it was the Bible, my reading of the Bible, growing up, my whole, you know, till I was like 16, reading copiously from the Bible, that inspired me to, that led me to all these other writings. That's what happened, because I got tired of the limiting interpretations that I was being force-fed. So I started reading from the Bible on my own, and I guess you could say, I'm not trying to sound all religious, but sorry, I almost dropped the book. But, you know, that's the truth. The Spirit inspired me. That Holy Spirit, whether you believe it or not, doesn't even matter. I feel it. I don't even believe it. I know it. I feel it. It's not limited to me or anyone. We all have that access to that. Anyway, so we're going to be listening to Third World, Tri Jah Love. Huh? And in the background, it's provided by Isaiah's Way. You know what? I'm subscribing to this guy right now. And I gave him 5 stars and whatever. The whole shebang. Anyway, so here we go. And I'm reading from Sirach 46, chapter 46. Here we go. Joshua, Caleb, and the judges. Valiant leader was Joshua, son of Nun, assistant to Moses in the prophetic office. Formed to be, as his name implies, the great savior of God's chosen ones. To punish the enemy, and to win the inheritance for Israel. What glory was his when he raised his arm to brandish his javelin against the city? And who could withstand him when he fought the battles of his Lord? Did he not by his power stop the sun so that one day became two? He called upon the Most High God when his enemies beset him on all sides. And God Most High gave answer to him in hailstones of tremendous power, which he rained down upon the hostile army, till on the slope he destroyed the foe, that all the doomed nations might know that the Lord was watching over his people's battles, and because he was a devoted follower of his God. And in Moses' lifetime showed himself loyal, he and Caleb, son of Jephunne, when they opposed the rebel assembly, averted God's anger from the people and suppressed the wicked complaint. Because of this, they were the only two spared from the 600,000 infantry to lead the people into their inheritance, the land flowing with milk and honey. And the strength he gave to Caleb remained with him even in his old age, till he won his way unto the summits of the land. His family too received an inheritance, that all the people of Jacob might know how good it is to be a devoted follower of that Lord. The judges also, each one of them, whose hearts were not deceived, who did not abandon their God. May their memory be ever blessed, their bones return to life from their resting place, and their names receive fresh luster in their children. Beloved of his people, dear to his Maker, dedicated from his mother's womb, consecrated to his Lord as a prophet was Samuel, the judge and priest. At God's word, he established the kingdom and anointed princes to rule the people. By the law of the Lord, he judged the nation, Samuel did, when he visited the encampments of Jacob. As a trustworthy prophet, he was sought out, and his words proved him true as a seer. As a rishi, because in Sanskrit, rishi means seer. He too called upon the Most High, Yah, and offered him a suckling lamb. Then the Lord thundered from heaven, and the tremendous roar of his voice was heard. He brought low the rulers of the enemy and destroyed all the lords of the Philistines. When Samuel approached the end of his life, he testified before his Lord and his anointed prince. He said, "No bribe or secret gift have I taken from any man." And no one dared gainsay him. Even when he lay buried, his guidance was sought. He made known to the king his fate. And from the grave, Samuel raised his voice as a prophet to put an end to wickedness. A little part of 47. After him came Nathan, who served in the presence of David. Like the choice fat of the sacred offerings, so was David in Israel. He made sport of lions as though they were kids, and of bears like lambs of the flock. As a youth, he slew the giant and wiped out the people's disgrace. When his hand let fly the sling stone that crushed the pride of Goliath, since he called upon the Most High God, who gave strength to his right arm to defeat the skilled warrior and raise up the might of his people. Therefore, the women sang his praises and ascribed to him tens of thousands when he assumed the royal crown. He battled and subdued the enemy on every side. He destroyed the hostile Philistines and shattered their power till our own day. With his every deed, he offered thanks to God Most High in words of praise. With his whole being, he loved his Maker, and daily he sang his praises. Ha ha ha. Try your love!